Hello everyone, my name is Ashwir Singh. Today we are going to discuss CNG, LPG as alternative fuels. This is the continuation of previous lecture of alternative fuels and engine turbology. So let's begin. So the contents of today's presentation is the availability of CNG and LPG and their properties, modification required to use in engine, use of LPG in SI engine, performance and emission characteristics of LPG and CNG. So the availability of CNG and LPG and their properties. So as we all know that CNG and LPGs are the gaseous form of petroleum fuel which are generally available at the sources of crude oil. These are the types of fuels which are on previous days of production of crude oil is abundant, as there were no technology to restore in separate chambers and make it use for further combustion. So as we all know, the CNG, the full form of name CNG, is compressed natural gas, and LPG is the liquefied petroleum gas. These both are the form of natural gas, but having the different state. So CNG can be used for SI and CI engine, depends upon the cetane number and octane number of the CNG configuration. Then LPG is generally preferred for SI engine, as it possesses all the similar characteristics as gasoline. The main constituent of natural gas is methane, and less than 10% is their ethane. So natural gas is more towards the greenhouse gases. So major component is having methane, and less than 10% is ethane. The very similar combustion properties as liquid petroleum gas, both having similar properties of combustions during the use. So the modification required for use CNG and LPG in conventional engines, like modification in inlet port to increase the swirl motion. As we can see in the figure that there is a swirl and the tumble. So in that swirl motion, the fumes of fluid is fuel has to be mixed with the air properly, so that the combustion can be carried out normally. And tumble is due to the injection of the fuel inside the combustion chamber. So these both the phenomena are required for the proper mixing of air to the fumes of fuel. So in that case, we cannot use normal inlet manifold, intake manifold, as we use in the conventional liquefied petroleum fuel engines. So we have to modify the inlet port accordingly. Then the replacement of glow plug with a spark plug in CI engine, as cetane number of CNG is far less than the cetane number of the diesel, so it get ignited at very high temperature. So at high cetane number, and easier and faster the auto ignition will occur. So in that case, we have to replace the glow plug with the spark plug, so that heat can be transfer to the combustion chamber. Then the replacement of CRDI with the gas injector. So as we already discussed, that CRDI is the common rail fuel injection system. So we cannot use that rail as similar as the gaseous fuel. So we have to replace that CRDI with the gaseous injector. Then reduction in the compression ratio, as the volumetric efficiency of this gaseous fuel is very low. So in that case, we cannot use as much as full volume of this combustion chamber. In that case, we have to reduce the compression ratio for getting the proper power from the engine. The storage system, storage cylinder at the place of conventional tank. So in that case, a safety valve will be there and a pressure valve will be there, so that the gaseous form of the gas cannot be released into the atmosphere, and the pressure of that gas should be maintained inside the storage tank. Then use of LPG as an SI engine fuel. It exhibits similar combustion characteristics as gasoline, except small reduction in power. By shifting to LPG as an automotive fuel, there can be consideration decrease in the environmental pollution as carbon dioxide, which our vehicles released, is reduced. Then LPG in the SI engine makes less noise as compared to the diesel one. Secondly, the LPG evaporates quickly. In case of spillage, fewer particles are produced. Then it reduces the dependency of petrol and diesel for driving automobiles. Due to higher octane rating of LPG, the combustion is smoother and knocking is eliminated. Then in the event when LPG leaks past the piston ring into the crankcase, it does not wash away the oil from the wall of the cylinder, which does not produce black carbon, as well as reduction in the black carbon. And there is no change in the lubrication process, so lubrication is always be there with the LPG. It cannot wash away with the leakage of LPG into the combustion chamber towards the piston side. Then use of LPG, these are the disadvantages. Mostly, so LPG has a high heat of evaporation, therefore the volumetric efficiency is reduced. It is handled under the pressure of about 80 bars, so the chances of leakage are always be there. Then complete combustion of fuel takes place, therefore more heat is produced and it is in is not good for the engine over a long run. Then as its odor is faint, it cannot easily detect in case of any leakage. Then the manufacturer warranty of the engine can be affected by the LPG uses. This is the economic background and disadvantages of using as LPG. Then to get it installed in your vehicle, you will need a trained LPG conversion specialist. So these are the disadvantages of using LPG as an SI engine fuel. So performance and emission characteristics, in the table we can see there are few properties of CNG and LPG, mostly having the constituent of methane and propane. So the auto ignition point is around 1350 degree Fahrenheit for methane, and it is for gasoline is 365 degree Fahrenheit. So the flammability limits, volume percent is 15%, 9.5% and 7.6%. As we can see, the air fuel ratio is 9.7 in methane and propane is 24.6. The motor octane number is 105 for propane and 111 for propane and 888 for gasoline. So the performance of and conventional SI engine is reduced with the use of CNG and LPG in form of power, but it covers the disadvantages through the emission characteristics. So less emissions there. The fuel gas must displace air. So switching a gasoline engine to CNG result in a reduction of about 9.3% in the amount of air that enters the cylinder and a corresponding reduction in the power. So that as the oxygen is less for the combustion because gas is already there, so in that case the power is reduced. The engine has to design to run on the fuel with the lowest octane number. This reduces the ability to achieve the highest performance when they're running on the fuel with the higher octane number. Then for both CNG and LPG, emission of NOx, NOx, that is nitrogen oxides, has have generally been considered to be a problem, with most tested showing higher level than from the gasoline fuel engines. Then the direct emission from the evaporation caused the contribution to the greenhouse gases, as methane is the more greenhouse property than propane, and both the CNG and LPGs have major portion of methane as a constituent, so they contributes to the greenhouse effect mostly. So these are the emission characteristics of the CNG and LPG. Thank you for today. That's all.